Hey guys, it's Go Fast with Class, and we're back again on the lathe project. I unearthed enough grease and grime off of this thing to probably bury one of the pyramids, but in the process I discovered this is actually a taper attachment, so it has degrees and minutes on the dial here, or indicator. The nuts that held it down looked like Bubba had his way with them, so I pulled a couple 3/8-16 nuts out of stock to put those back on. And then these rails here are what goes across right here. They bridge this area here and keep this guy in line. The most disappointing thing, and I guess disappointing isn't really the right term because I have a taper attachment on my lathe, is there's no gib in here. I don't know what happened to it. I took it apart and it's just not there. There's gib screws that you can see. There's four of those guys. But there's no gib, so I'll have to make one. Small price to pay. So here's a shot with a side cover open, and you can see, grab my light, you can see the gears here that run the lead screw are actually in pretty decent shape, considering how crusty everything else is. They're dirty, but when I spun through these, there's no missing teeth. There's no what appears to be excessive wear on anything. They just all need a really, really, really good cleaning. As I mentioned on the previous video, there's a thing here called inchometric. So what you can do is you can actually swing this piece right here. So there's three different positions, and one of them does inch, one of them does metric screw threading, and then the other one is just a feed, so that controls your lead screw feed rate. And obviously all of that jazz is controlled right through here, through this panel, through these little guys. So it's pretty cool, pretty excited about that. Here's a shot inside the gearbox. It's pressurized oiling, which is a good deal obviously, but down here is a pressurized oil pump, so as the headstock spins, it's constantly picking up oil, which is pretty low, bringing it up through this tube, through the manifold, and then feeding it throughout these guys right here, these other copper tubes. This one just sprays up, apparently. It's kind of pinched off, but it looks like it's got some holes in it. Anyway, all of these gears also look perfect. So there's a little bit of rust and a lot of crud inside there, but there's nothing bad. There's nothing that makes me feel like I've got a bad purchase. Everything is, there's no chipped teeth, there's no missing gears, everything works. It's actually pretty fantastic. And right down here you can see this beast of a three-phase motor, which is also filthy, just like everything else in the lathe, but it turns free and it doesn't smell burnt. But I've not plugged it in because I don't have a phase converter, so I've got to get that. That is all for now.